everyone in the world needs something. I need something, you need something. But to be more precise, according to Maslow's pyramid of needs, physiological and biological needs are the basics. However, others are also concerned about Wi-Fi, the internet, and electricity. Electronic devices help us with organizing our day, working, studying, having fun, and whatnot. It is very hard to imagine a day without them. What if you have planned to do some work, or your girl is gonna raid that boss that you always wanted, and suddenly there is a power outage? All this can be avoided with the use of revolutionary technology that came from the future. Behold, the uninterruptible power supply by Qoltec. Spikes, energy fluctuations, and power breaks cannot be controlled or anticipated. Uninterruptible power supply, or UPS, provides emergency power to your operational components and allows them to safely shut down in case of mains failure. It supports a broad spectrum of electronic equipment such as telecommunication devices, delicate electronics, PCs and PCs peripherals. We can distinguish three main types of UPSs: offline, line interactive, and online. The simplest of the three is the offline or the standby UPS. The power from the mains is connected straight to the load and the charger. In the case of mains failure or power fluctuations, the switch changes the supply from mains to the battery. The line interactive UPS is the modification of the offline UPS. It has automatic voltage regulator that senses the fluctuations and stabilizes the output power. As a result, battery life is prolonged and the power that goes to the load is processed. If the mains power is too low, then it switches to the batteries. Online UPS always provides power to the load through double conversion. During proper operation, the power from the mains is being converted from AC to DC. The DC voltage charges the battery and being converted back to AC through the inverter. This means that during a blackout, the power instantaneously goes to the load with almost no transfer time. In order to choose the proper UPS, you need to consider the power consumption of the connected devices, their sensitivity to power fluctuations, and their working environment. Let's begin with determining what is the most sensitive device to power fluctuations or energy spikes that is going to be connected to the UPS. It can be any device that does not have a proper circuit protection. It can be an old device or a low quality one. In this case, you should think about investing in line interactive UPS or an online. If your electric appliances are not from the steam engine era, offline UPS should be more than enough. The UPSs are usually defined by volt amperes. The higher the value, the more power it can output. In order to transfer volt amperes into watts, find the power factor of the UPS and multiply it by the volt ampere value. With the known power consumption, now we can determine how big the UPS has to be. And by big, I mean how much capacity it should have. And more capacity means more time to finish the work. As an example, let's take this PC and those two monitors. Plug all of them to the same outlet and measure the power consumption. The power meter showed us that the maximum power consumption of the computer and the two monitors was around 150 watts. If we are about to use a UPS of 600 watts, such as this one, we are gonna last between 20 to 25 minutes. But if we are about to use a UPS of 300 watts, we are gonna last only 5 minutes. Go to the website and choose the UPS with the proper capacity. TME offers a variety of uninterruptible power supplies that will make sure your work and your electronic devices are safe regardless of the main situation. For more information, you can always refer to the datasheet, and this general explanation should help you to choose the proper UPS. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button and check our other videos. For more information, check the description or visit our website. Thank you for watching.